Load testing your web applications is critical for detecting performance issues, verifying you fixed them, and then ensuring you don't regress those issues. Unfortunately, provisioning suitable test rigs is time-consuming and expensive for the kinds of loads many of our applications support. The load test service uses your existing investment in web performance and load tests. It simply provides infrastructure to more easily let you generate load and collect performance data. Let's take this existing load test and have it execute using the load test service. It's as easy as modifying the local.testsettings file. When we run the load test now, our tests are uploaded to the service and agents are acquired on the fly based on the number of virtual users you've specified. Tests are run during any warm-up period you've specified, and then during test execution, key metrics are shown in a chart and grouped into performance and throughput counters. At the completion of the test, you can download and view the detailed report, which is exactly the same set of rich metrics as on-premise load testing. Increasing the load involves simply increasing the number of agents I want to spin up in the cloud. I can then change the load pattern to specify more virtual users. Increasing the load from 100 to 2,000 virtual users using on-premise load testing would have involved adding more physical machines to our test rig. We've shown that our application can easily scale up to 2,000 concurrent users. We've done it easily using the load test service. Finally, it's easy to keep track of your service usage using the load test manager. You can see who has run tests in your account and how many virtual user minutes have been consumed. You can also easily open historical test results. In this video, you've seen that Microsoft's load testing service makes it easy for developers to generate load from the cloud to test your applications using real-world scale.